My name is Rashmi Chaudhary, and I have selected my topic as Types of Human Communication as the seminar topic for MLI 101, Information Communication and Society. So let's start with the presentation. So first of all, we all know what is communication, but generally, if we want to give its definition, communication can be defined as the exchange of ideas, information, and knowledge between the sender and the receiver. And there are several types of communication. It can be characterized as it can be categorized as non-vocal and vocal communication, non-verbal and verbal communication, intrapersonal communication, interpersonal communication, group communication, public or mass communication. Let's talk about non-vocal and vocal communication first. So non-vocal and vocal communication refers to the use of signs, signals, and symbols. Signs can be understood by only by the trained staff, for example, traffic signs. Signals allow a flow of information. Means by signals, you get some information. So the use of signals in railway systems, these are examples of signals. And if you talk about symbols, they are usually complex. For example, the symbols in classification schemes. Then let's talk about vocal communication. Vocal communication is any type of communication which uses human vocal cords. For example, it can be shouting, crying, spoken languages, etc. Now let's figure out non-verbal and verbal communication. Non-verbal communication includes actions such as gestures, vocalizations, facial expressions, tone of voice, touch, etc. Non-verbal communication can be further categorized in seven categories. First is paralinguistics. It means the pitch of your voice, the hesitation in your voice, the loudness of your voice. Kinesics means facial expressions, your eye movements. Haptics, your touch. You mean, the shaking hands, patting on somebody's back, etc. Proxemics, interpersonal space between two people. How far is somebody standing means a lot. It can be different meanings. Appearance of somebody, like hairstyles, etc. Chronemics means time. How much time somebody is taking to respond. Sometimes a silence or a gap of long time between two sentences means a lot. Iconics, interpretation of symbols, like international traffic signals. Verbal communication refers to the use of words. So these were verbal and non-verbal communication. And we can further classify communication as per its levels also. For example, the number one is intrapersonal communication. It means when a person talks to oneself. It can be meditation, it can be reading a book, and it can be different things. You talk to yourself when you see at the mirror, etc. Interpersonal communication. It can happen between more than two persons. Next is group communication. Many people are involved in group communication. For example, corporate meetings. In such type of communication, the shifting of speaker and listeners keep on shifting. The listeners and the speakers keep on shifting. Sometimes some other person is a listener, next time that listener can be a speaker. The next is public or mass communication. A person or a group of person address a large audience through a medium. That medium can be electronic, print, film, internet, etc. And these are the references. Thank you.